My dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, heartfelt greetings of peace from Rome. Thank you, and may the Lord bless you. Brothers and sisters, we are faced with a crisis in the church that we must all meet together. As Archbishop Hon has conveyed in his powerful letter, we need to be ever more mindful of the victims of abuse in our society and within our church. We care foremost for the victims and are committed to do whatever we can to make the wrong right. We are determined that those who commit acts of child sexual abuse will be held accountable for it. But as Archbishop Hon has related, there are unintended consequences in the bill that recently passed the legislature. We believe that the legislators in passing the bill resist the time restrictions on lawsuits against institutions such as the church that have employed those accused of child sexual abuse. Did not understand that the bill threatens the very existence of our parishes, schools, social agencies that are so central to the life of almost every person on Guam. We don't agree with the bill, but we understand why the Guam legislature has acted to lift the statute of limitations and open the church to liability for the actions of abusive priests. The stories that have been coming out are truly troubling. We understand the passion, anger, and calls for justice coming from voices all over the island. We should all be outraged by what has gone on and should be doing everything in our power to bring the abusers to account and help the survivors. But simply opening up the church to total liability for the actions of abusive priests, some of whom have not resided on Guam for decades, is not the way. We are calling on the governor to veto the bill and for all our elected leaders to revisit the bill and let everyone in the community participate in drafting a new bill that will lift the statute of limitations on suing abusers without endangering all the services that are so vital to all the people who serve. Please consider signing the petition that will be available at the conclusion of Mass in support of the veto of Bill 326-33 that will be submitted to Governor Calvo on Monday, September 21st, 2016. Thank you for considering this request for the good of the Church, and may Our Lady be with us and guide us at this time. May the Lord be with you.